your review. In this video, ACCUSOUND 8.6 XD series reference. What does that say? Extra definition, double 8-inch floor standing tower speakers. Now let's start off this review. On the right here, or on the sides, you see an extremely high gloss finish. As you can see, there's me. A glossy finish where there's something like the remote. You can read the remote backwards, that's how glossy the finish is. Oops. Okay. So, 4-inch mid-range. Cabinet is sealed like that. For the mid-range to have its own cabinet. The tweeter is in the same cabinet as the mid-range, but obviously it doesn't move that much air because it's got a mid-range crossover. And then double 8-inch mid-low subwoofer sort of thing. There's a front ported. You can see the front port here. They come with grills. I will get them one second. They have grills. This goes on the front like that. Clicks in. Nothing special, just your typical grill that just sits on it like that. Nothing special looking. But I'm gonna leave the grills off for these videos, just so you can see what they look like under the grill. Now let's start off by saying, dual 8-inch, they're huge. Here's my towers, my babies. Huge, massive. They're not that much different in height, but that's because they're T-line rear ported. These are front ported dual 8s. Box is fairly well braced up here, obviously because of that second chamber, but down here, it sounds pretty hollow. So, what do they do? What do they rate? On eBay, they say they cost $1,000 retail for the pair. I doubt it, really do doubt it. But they say because they're on sellout, even though they've been on sellout forever and they still manufacture them, you can pick them up for $300 for the pair. They rate them for 200 watts. I don't really think they're 200 watts. 30 to 25 kilohertz, so not bad. I don't really think they go down to 30. I'm not sure about 25 kilohertz because you can't actually hear that high. But as I said, dual 8-inch woofers, 5-inch. They say it's a 5-inch, but I believe it's a 4-inch mid-range and a 1-inch soft dome tweeter. Dimensions, they're 1,062 mil high, 248 wide, and 315 mil deep. They're pretty heavy, to be honest. So I don't think it says the weight. Oh, yes, it does. 17 kilos a speaker. It's pretty reasonable. Obviously, dual 8s again. I think that's really it. Yeah, there's nothing really to go on about. Now it's just on to what I've got to say. Alright, so don't care about the laptop anymore. Towers. Flat response. They are quite mid-range focused. Obviously, they're not 200 watts, but they're probably like 100 and something. I've got a 20 watt amp powering them, so I can't drive them hard. At flat frequency response, sorry. They're quite mid-range focused, obviously mid-range driver, but I don't know. I'm not sure if it was the amp I did listening on before this. I haven't actually listened to them on that amplifier, but the treble they needed to be more of, and the bass really didn't sound like two 8-inch drivers. It sounded like, well, I'll be straight out honest, with what I was listening to them on last time, they have more bass on a flat frequency response. I'm going to have a quick listen to this song because I know it has a bass kick. I'll tell you what I think in a sec. Okay, so that back. The bass isn't too bad. They still have more bass on a flat frequency response, but the magnet on this 5-inch driver probably weighs and has more motor force than both those 8s because, look, they're made in China. They're not the most expensive. Like, yes, those components are made in China, but they're made in China Okay, here's what you gotta think. $50 crossover in each speaker. $30 woofers in each speaker. $30 tweeter in each speaker. You're looking $100 and $200 terminals. You're looking $250-ish. Around $250. And you build the box. Costs about $300 to get that. These cost $300 to have crossover terminals, a high piano gloss finish, mid-range tweeter, dual 8-inch woofers, front-ported, built. You gotta have them built for you. You're not building them, so there's a labor that goes into these. So they're not the most high-quality component. No, they're not. But they don't sound half bad. They do bottom out quite easily. Not what I mean bottom out, they can distort if you give them a fair bit of power. The woofers in them can get really warm. I've had them warm before. Give them a little bit of bass, even though amp isn't very powerful. It sounded like it stuttered then on that bass note, but that could have been my iPod and not the speakers. Sort of, yeah. So, from a flat frequency response, which is what they're getting, mid-range focus. Trebles aren't as detailed as I like them. And again, I have air motion tweeters, and they're the best things I've ever heard, to be honest. Air motion tweeters. I haven't really sat down and listened to any high-end stereos. I've been in rooms with high-end stereos. I've been in a room with Bowers & Wilkins 801s. With like $50,000 worth of amps and stuff, and I really wanted to listen, but we couldn't. I don't know. The design, I'm not sure. It's a bit weird, but rubber surround on the dust cap. I'd say it's, I don't think that's paper, that's like a rubbery sort of thing, but yeah. These are by amp or by wireable. You can see, I can't get my phone back there. There you go. By ampable or by wireable. Top one's for tweeters and mid range, and the bottom one is for the two dual 8-inch woofers. The 8 ohms, if you have them together like that, 8 ohm load. On the multimeter, they read at 6. They do rate them for 8. So yeah, I think that's really it for the review side of things. Now onto the sound demo.